We're going to get the program started. I get my attention, please. I'd like to see. We're going to start this morning's event. We have the honor of having Lord Bubba McDonald, the chairman of the Georgia Public Service Commission. He is going to rank a succinct for us. God bless America to get us started. Thank you, sir.
While the storm clouds gather far across the sea, let us pledge allegiance to this land that's free. Let us all be grateful to this land so fair as we lift our voices in a solemn prayer. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans wide with hope, God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet home.
Get all the elected officials, if you don't mind, coming up here. All elected officials, that includes Mr. Goldsall. I think we count on you to be elected in November, no doubt. Michael Williams, Senator Williams, will you come up, please? We need all elected officials, Todd Jones, Bar McDonald. Coming up here, Todd. It's obvious we all stand with Secretary Brian Kemp, the governor, and we're all very proud to be here today. I'm going to go ahead and give the microphone over to Senator Williams. He has a few words he'd like to say. I always like doing that.
All right, well, first of all, thank you again for all of you coming out today to show their support for the next governor of Georgia. I just want to share one quick story with you about why I have come out so much in favor of Brian Kemp. While I was on the campaign trail with him, we got to interact a lot with each other. I was able to talk to him. My wife got to know his wife pretty well, and they are truly a stand-up family and guy. And he illustrated that one time when we were in, I think it was Cobb County, it was one of these events, and one of my supporters comes over and says, "Michael, can I take a picture with you?" She says, "Sure." So she taps the gentleman on the shoulder, says, "Do you mind taking a picture of us?" It was Brian Kemp. And Brian says, "Sure, I'll take a picture." So he's taking a picture of his competitor with one of my supporters. And in the middle of it, she realizes, "Oh my goodness, I just asked Brian Kemp to take a picture." So then she looks over at me and says, "Michael, will you take my picture with Brian Kemp?" And I said, "Sure." But that's the kind of guy that Brian is. He's down to earth, he's humble, and he's going to make a great governor. And also, he is not bought and paid for by lobbyists and special interests. Thank you, Brian. Thank you for your training. And we look forward to your victory party.
Does anybody else want to say any words? Anybody want to step up? All righty. Yeah, we did. So now what we're all here for is, Mr. Kemp, will you please come up and say a few words for us? Mr. Kemp, will you please come up and say a few words for us?
Well, thank y'all so much for coming out. I want to first thank Todd for providing us this great venue and breakfast, and I know himself and a lot of his supporters really worked hard to get the word out about this. It's great to see such a good crowd on a Saturday morning, and we understand there's a lot of other things going on, especially when people are teeing off now that the sun's come out. So I have great appreciation for that. I want to thank all the local elected officials and those that are serving at the Gold Dome for turning out this morning for us. We really appreciate your support. You know, our support with grassroots and local elected officials in all 159 counties is unprecedented, I will say. And that is what has gotten us in the position to be where we are right now and where I think we'll be on Tuesday night. So I'm not going to get into naming names, but I do want to thank all of you for your commitment. But also not just being a name on the list, but being out there and working to get the vote out for us. It means a lot. I know how much you can do. I do not take that for granted. My family does not either. I know most of y'all got to see Marty and the girls. Not sure what's going on with Mike. But thanks a lot for that. I also just want to thank Michael Williams. You know, Michael was the first person to endorse my campaign in the runoff. Never one bit of hesitation. He has done every single thing that we've asked him to do. He hadn't complained when we've been so busy that we haven't kept him in the loop on things, because he understands, you know, what's going on right now. And Michael, I thought you, when you said you were going to say that one story, I thought you were going to tell the one about when we were in, I'm trying to remember what county that was. It was somewhere in West Georgia. And both you and I were at the gas station before an event, and I was pumping gas. And I turn around and there's Michael, and he was either in the store or just got finished pumping gas, and he looked at me and he goes, "You pump your own gas?" I was by myself. I said, "You're thinking about the other guy." But anyway, I thought that was kind of funny. But also I have good appreciation for people who can fight hard and then put that behind them and move on. And that's why I'm so excited that we've had so many people that have come to our team. We appreciate that. We appreciate Hunter Hill's endorsement. That was a big day for us on Tuesday. Clay Tippin's endorsement on Wednesday. And that got overshadowed a little bit, because literally while Clay Tippin's and I were standing at the podium, I'm looking at a television camera and we're answering questions like we've done with Hunter the day before. And everybody in the background is all looking at their phones at the same time, and then they're jumping up and down and running outside. And I was like, what in the world is going on? I'm trying to stay poised and focused. And we wrapped up and they're like, "You're not going to believe this tweet." And somebody said it to me on the phone. I was like, man alive. Donald Trump is just endorsed. This about that tweet and that endorsement, it was not timid whatsoever. Him and the vice president are all in. We are in the win, and I'm very much appreciative of that. And I appreciate the president's willingness to stand with me, and I'll promise you, we'll all be standing with him in 2020. And I want to thank the Trump bus for being here today. Quick recap, because we've been talking about, you know who the candidates are. We've talked about the issues. I mean, it's all down to getting the vote out now. But we have had a fantastic 2 weeks. Week before last, Sunday after church and lunch, we went up to Barrow County and Winder to this unbelievable little barbecue place, and we ate barbecue for 7 days in a row while we were on. We drove 1,860 miles, which to put in perspective is, that would have put us 100 miles short of San Diego, California. We went to 37 counties, 40 stops in 7 days. And it was amazing on the ground, even before all this happened this week. People were fired up and just, great momentum. that Friday, we got the poll from the, I think it was from the AJC that had us up by 3 points, because the race had basically been flat since we started in the primary, which is why my opponent immediately started attacking me, as he did everybody else in the race after he begged us, if you'll remember, Michael, to run a clean campaign and talk about the issues. And we have continued to do that, but we've also pushed back on the negative campaign and quite honestly, the dishonesty of those. But we had that poll over the weekend. We got our internal poll back on Monday morning that showed us up 45-40, which we didn't release because we didn't want people getting too confident. We wanted to keep working hard. And that's exactly what we were doing through Tuesday when Hunter endorsed. And then, well, even Monday with the news that in the Cagle camp, we still had Neil Bortz tweeting and people should vote for Brian Kemp. Randy Evans, former colleague on the state election board of mine. I worked with Randy a long, long time. I worked with him in state party politics as he, as you all know, was the parliamentarian for state conventions. I was on the rules committee at the 12th national convention in Tampa when Romney got nominated, and Randy and I worked on the rules committee and things of that nature. And he can't endorse because he's the ambassador to Luxembourg, but somebody asked him who he voted for, and he decided to let him know by tweeting it out, and we were completely okay with that. Randy has a great grassroots following, but he's also connected to the Republican Party donors and, you know, just well respected. So that was really big for us that day. I had been talking to Newt Gingrich about endorsing, and I thought he was going to do that. Well, let's see, Tuesday we got Hunter Hill's endorsement. So that kept us back rolling. Huge, you know, huge momentum for us there. Wednesday morning, I thought Newt was going to endorse. And it never came all day. And then we got to the Tippins thing, and I was like, man, I wonder what happened to Newt. I hope things hadn't gone off the rails. Did something happen I don't know about? And then we got the president's endorsement, and I was like, no, I think we're all good. Then we got the president's endorsement. I was like, no, I think we're all good. So I finally got home after, it's been crazy since then. So if you have texted me or called me and I haven't responded yet, I'm still trying to get called up from the momentum that caused, quite honestly. But I woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning, as I've been doing every morning for 15 months now. And I had a text on my phone, and it said, check your Twitter, Newt. And I was like, so Newt endorsed. Obviously, the vice president endorsed shortly thereafter. And then we started talking to them about possibilities in the days ahead. And as you all know, we're very excited we had to cancel our rally in Hall County, because I'm going to tell y'all, we were fighting hard in Hall County, make no mistake about it, and we're going to do well up there. But we had to cancel our rally because we had to go to Macon, Georgia and be with the vice president today. So that's going to be a great rally. I think we have 1,500, 2,000 people coming to that. I think Michael's coming down for that. We'll have a lot of folks there with us, uniting to bring this thing home on Tuesday night. So we're looking forward to a great day. We got a very busy day tomorrow. We'll be going to church at Rock Springs Church in the morning. And then we have several other events in West Georgia and end up in Roswell tomorrow night in Fulton County for another big rally. So we're gonna work all the way through, Tuesday, whenever the polls close, probably at 7 o'clock normally, but we'll see. So we've got that. Monday we have a busy day doing mostly press and some interviews and things of that nature. So things are going really well. But let me just tell you what we have and what people need to think about in the days ahead, which there are only a few now. But this runoff to me, what I've been telling people on the bus tour is we have been on the Pudding Georgians' first bus tour. I've been talking about that for 15 months. It is. That we need a governor that's going to put Georgians first ahead of the special interests, like Michael said, the politically correct, the status quo, and those that are here illegally. And that is exactly who I am. And as you all know, you know, as an unapologetic conservative, my ads say that, and it caused some people on the left a little bit of heartburn. But you know what? That's what people are wanting. And as I've traveled around the state, they are asking me, you know, who is up there fighting for us? You know, who's fighting for us, the people down here that nobody's thinking about? And that is what I've been talking about. That's exactly what I'm going to do. I have prided myself on my record of telling people what my agenda is, like I've done with our conservative four-point plan, and then actually doing that when I get in office. And that is a simple pledge that you have. But you can trust me to do it. You can trust me to do it because I've done it before, and I pride myself on doing that, and that is exactly what I'm going to do. In this race on Tuesday, and if you're trying to convince people that haven't decided who they're going to vote for between now and Tuesday, to me the most important thing is trust. Because you can trust me to do as I say. I've done it before. You can ask people that I served with in the legislature. You can ask people I've served with in the Secretary of State's office. Even people that are out there that are supporting my opponent in the runoff that are bashing me right now, if you ask them, has he helped your constituents any time you've asked, if at all possible? I guarantee every single one of them would. Because that is the how we've operated in the Secretary of State's office. Up on the other hand, we have someone that will do and say anything to retain 24 years of power in state government. And that is not what we need in our next government. We need somebody that's going to put you first. Somebody that's willing to change their principles for politics or campaign cash is just wrong. And it is about trust. So I would just continue all, the best thing that you all can do is to help us get the vote out. First of all, get the Kemp vote out. We've had so much great consolidation with people like Michael Williams, people in, you know, Sam Teasley's here, Mike Dudgeon, and other people that may have been on other teams to start with, but we're on board now. You know, we're on one team. We're not worried about what happened in the past. This is all about the future now, and we can all help be a part of that. And I'm ready to lead that charge to do that. But we got to get our people back out. If we do that, we will win. And we should, because our people have more intensity than the other side does. That's just a fact. And that's because of the statewide base that I've worked hard to get and that we've implemented over the last 15 months. And then for the undecideds, you just got to tell them the truth. You know, I had a reporter ask me the other day, he said, well, what about all these negative ads? You know, how do you feel about that? And I said, well, I'll just say one thing. I know this, and my family knows this, and people like Bubba McDonald, that have literally known my wife since she was a child and known me for I don't know how long, and Lauren as well, and their family, they know that the truth is on our side. And the truth, as they say, will set you free. So we're going to be set free on Tuesday night, and then no one will work harder to beat Stacey Abrams in November. So thank you all so much.
Change and Thank you.